Sati Daakshaayani. Daksha Prajapati married Prasuti, daughter of Swayambhuva Manu, sister of Devahuti. He had 16 daughters. The last was called Sati, Uma, and was given in marriage to Rudra, Lord Shiva. Once all the gods, celestials and saints assembled together for performing a yajna, and Brahma and Lord Shiva had also come and the yajna was going on. Then Daksha Prajapati also came there and all the assembly stood up to respect him except Brahma and Lord Shiva. Daksha prostrated to Brahma and took his proper seat, but his eyes were cast on Lord Shiva. He was annoyed that his son-in-law did not show him respect. So he began to address the whole assembly, accusing Rudra. This person brings discredit to all gods. He's always lazy, does not work. By him, the righteous path is tarnished. He has no modesty. He has married my daughter, who is equal to Savitri, wife of Brahma, in the presence of the fire god, Brahmins and relatives. On seeing me, he closes his eyes like a monkey. He does not feel that he is like a son to me, having become my son-in-law. Let it be, he does not even speak a word of inquiry, though not salutation. He always desists from work. He has no shame. He does not know respect. He is a friend of lunatics, remains naked, is surrounded by the dead and the devils. He is the lord of lazy servants. He is smeared with ashes from the burial ground and bones are his decorations. He is ferocious, lives in the burial ground unattended. His hair is locked. It's a pity that he is called Shiva, auspicious, though he is always inauspicious. I have unwittingly given my daughter to him. Not being satisfied with these words, he cursed Shiva that thenceforth Shiva would not get a share in any sacrifice. All these words, though spoken by him out of contempt, happened to be true and were words of praise for Lord Shiva. Daksha's action was condemned by all the assembly, and so he got up in anger and returned home. Lord Shiva calmly returned to Kailas, though with a disturbed mind. But his vehicle, Nandi, could not control his anger and so cursed that Daksha would have the face of a goat thereafter. The displeasure between Daksha and Rudra continued for long. Sometime later, Daksha himself commenced a great sacrifice without propitiating Rudra, though such a procedure was not sanctioned by the Vedas. Because he was a Prajapati, many gods, celestials and saints went to attend the same. Sati saw many of them going with their consorts, talking highly of the sacrifice while going by the aerial route. She too yearned to witness the sacrifice. She wanted to see her mother and also her sisters, who would have come there with eagerness like herself to see the sacrifice. Sati approached Lord Shiva and expressed her strong desire and said that a formal invitation was not necessary to visit one's own father's, guru's and friend's place. Lord Shiva explained to her that her wish was noble and her idea good, but they could visit those places only as long as they were favorably disposed towards them. But the very fact that she was the wife of Rudra was sufficient cause for her to be dishonored by her father. Dishonor by one's own people was worse than death. Since you will not have peace by remaining there, you may go. Since you will not have peace by remaining here, you may go, he said. Sati, having heard the wise counsel of her lord, became very nervous. And though trembling, she could not suppress her desire. She started and a large retinue followed her, including Nandi. They all reached the Yajnashala. The assembly at the Yajnashala did not offer her any reception, but kept quiet because of the possible wrath of Daksha. Daksha did not welcome her, But her mother and sisters embraced her with great love. Sati saw that the sacrifice was being conducted without giving a proper place for Lord Shiva. She was filled with anger. She began to chastise her father, who, with I am the body concept, was showing all disrespect and disgrace to her lord. She said it was shameful to be called the daughter of Daksha, and so she sat in the Yajnashala and with her own Yoga Shakti kindled the fire in her heart and directed her full mind towards her lord. Her body became ashes in no time. Everybody began to condemn Daksha for his arrogance and ill-treatment of his own daughter. When Sati was thus lost, the servants of Rudra began to manhandle the whole sacrifice. Seeing the danger, Bhrigu Maharishi invoked the gods for rescue, who came and drove away the servants of Rudra. Meanwhile, Narada had come to Kailas and explained to Lord Shiva what had taken place. The Lord took out a lock of hair from his head, threw it on the ground with anger. Veerbhadra, with 1,000 hands and an angry look, came out of the lock of hair and awaited orders from the Lord, who directed him to go and destroy the sacrifice and its agents. Veerbhadra, with a big army, went to the Yajnashala, destroyed it, squeezed the head out of Daksha and drove away the gods. The gods went to Brahma and prayed for protection. Brahma told them that they had been properly punished for their disrespect to Lord Shiva, and it was only he who could pardon them, and so he led them to Kailas. When they reached Kailas, they found Lord Shiva conversing with Narada in a pleasant mood. His anger had disappeared. Brahma praised him and requested that he be pleased to relieve the harm done to Daksha and others, and the sacrifice started by Daksha might be successfully concluded. Lord Shiva agreed accordingly, and all of them proceeded to the Yajnashala. Daksha was brought back to life by attaching a goat's head to his body. The injuries to others were duly healed up. Then Daksha apologized for his misconduct towards Lord Shiva, who was all pure and ever merciful. The sacrifice was proceeded with. Lord Narayana was pleased to appear and appreciate the successful conclusion of the same. He explained to them all that Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva were one. There was no difference in them. Only fools make a difference where no difference exists. Just as the legs, hands and body in one person cannot be thought of as different from him. He blessed them all and returned to his abode. Daakshaayani, daughter of Daksha, after her body was burnt by her own Yoga Shakti, was again born to Himavan, the king of the mountains, as Parvati, daughter of Parvata Raja, and became the consort of Lord Shiva again, and occupied a half portion of his body.